everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. What a game we have for you here. The first meeting of the year between two of the NFL's most hostile divisional rivals. This matchup always among the most anticipated games of the regular season. It's the Rams going up against the Cardinals. So let's send you out to the Valley of the Sun as we welcome in our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Right now, in a big uphill climb.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Rams, they too were losers last week, so they're also hoping to get back in the win column.
Something's got to give in this one, right? Both teams.
So out come the Cardinals now for their opening drive. They're led onto the field by their veteran quarterback, the former USC Trojan, Carson Palmer.
Starting quarterback.
Now a play fake here on first down. And down he goes on the pressure from the...
There you go.
And now whistle.
Neutral zone infraction. Defense.
Ready. One. 18.
On second down, Johnson. And some room to roam now. And he's brought down. And a nice kick.
Just started as a fourth string back, didn't he?
He certainly did, but boy, he produces a year one honor. Remember, can run it. He can catch it. He was a
wide. Let's go. One. 18. Check that.
They'll run it now. Out of the gun. Ooh, with a juke. Fights off another.
I think the second tackler would have
worked. Second down run. And at that yardage gain, they can run that play on any down.
The first down carry here for Johnson. And he's brought down. A nice pick.
And to be frank about it, they like calling pass plays better than they like calling running plays. And with the way that they're running it right now, that's going to open.
Palmer gives to Johnson. And he's going to get this inside the
field. Defense, you've got to figure out how to keep things in front of you because you know there's three levels. Defensive line, linebackers, and into the secondary. And if the third level's leading your team and quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Johnson. And he will have the first down before he's
low and get leverage on the offensive lineman. But they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
And able to break one tackle, but they
feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And Palmer gives to Johnson. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line. Palmer now to throw on third down. And that is caught. Touchdown. Gore on the opening drive. A post to the tight end for six. Gosh, those guys are so tough.
To decide how you want to treat them. Are they a wide receiver? Are they a big extra blocker on the field? Or are they a hybrid and caught in between? So are you going to use a linebacker? Are you going to use a safety? Are you going to even move a corner in? They have an answer for all three of those positions.
So out come the Rams now for their first possession. They're led onto the field by their quarterback, the former Houston Cougar. They go play action here on first down. And his first look is incomplete.
Nothing he can't do on the football field. If you're a defense, that's a long day trying to prepare for Todd Gurley.
And not a whole lot doing there. Throwing on third down, Keenum. Nowhere to escape, and he goes to Hecker to punt it away. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So I just bring us right back to what you said. How we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move
so many ways. Throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do.
Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man.
Now Palmer on first down. Here, this is caught on the left side, Jerron Brown. And he'll work it in.
What they saw in preparation, what they saw in film, is a defense that likes to get out fast in terms of coverage, meaning they either bail out or they give them a lot of space to throw the underneath stuff. So they decide, see? And when I got introduced to it, I thought I was meeting their starting tight end, not their starting quarterback.
And he is in for six. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. And for Johnson, his first touchdown.
In a variety of ways. David Johnson out of the University of Northern Iowa
You know, he was a receiver there first in college before moving to running back.
To go now. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure up in the end zone.
All right, here we go.
Now Keenum throwing on second. Caught here left side by Brad. 20, 10, 5, touchdown LA. Kenny Brent. Well, that was the fly route for a touchdown, and since he caught that one and scored it, I got to tell the story. Before the game, we were standing there. He was running deep route. The first quarter. Now it's time for the second quarter kickoff, as we'll see one following the score on the final play before break. Now to return. This is David Johnson. And he nearly broke that for more, but as for the defense, obviously they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? What they come up with, I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive.
Threes of one-yard gains running the ball. If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along, you control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
And he's got Gresham. And he's going to have them. That's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. An interception in that game in Super Bowl 50, maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
It's brought incomplete. It's John Brown.
It happened, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now's a play caller. Because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do so against Larry Fitzgerald. You're really holding your breath as a defensive guy because his ability to run such...
When you make 9 Pro Bowls in your first 12 years, you might want to give him a little bit more coverage than that.
Yes, not just athletic ability. He's a thinking man. It won't be easy.
On third and goal, Palmer. And probably the wise decision there.
Easy one.
And Catanzaro's kick is what caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the... Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as...
Watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard.
Here we go now.
On second down, here's Keenum. And he's taken down.
Gets yanked back the other. 15 yards is the right call.
Throwing on first down is Keenum. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. But they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about that. Super tough.
There's Johnson. He's been busy this afternoon. And he went backwards.
His body in such a way that you can't get a good clean block on it. He slides through holes and slides
back. And down he goes. They set. And that'll be off the crossbar. And cruel punishment there to be denied by the crossbar.
If you're going to hit from that distance, sometimes you're going to need a little luck. And unfortunately for him, this time.
Here we go now.
Again, they run with Gurley. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 42nd.
A short run, and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes that dish was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. They were all done.
All right, here we go. Green.
On second down, here's Keenum. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to...
A lot of relief for the defensive guys. When they get in the film next week, they're going to want to know what happened. Where was the breakdown that almost allowed a touchdown?
Got his man over the middle. This Orlando, he'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of play. So we look forward to that.
And I'm looking if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
To throw on second down is Keenum. That's complete to his tight end. This is Lance Kendricks. And he's going to take this one in.
Throw it to them when all else fails? Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's
for the PAT. And this is up and good to make it a 17. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Fairly short kick, taking it to 14 here. And he nearly broke that for more, but as...
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the...
And the Rams got him. They bring him down.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds...
And play is stopped here.
18.
They go to Johnson again. And he'll get up near the... And the Rams are going to... And not what he was hoping.
That attitude. How do I get better? How does my team get better? How do we find a way to win the game?
Well, he's hoping to lead his team to a successful drive.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Here we go.
Keenum on first down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
You want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. Completes it to Quick. And he works it to the 30 unit to see about getting 3 points. It'll be a 47-yard attempt from the left hash. So we've hit halftime. Just a field goal separating these two teams in the postgame. We're ready to get to the third quarter. Fielded about a yard deep. Oh, nice move. And he's up across. Probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but over.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. And brought down, but not before reaching.
Nice gain. The defense has felt great about what they have going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Now Keenum. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he's brought down. 15 yards.
Very, very difficult for a DB to stay with it.
Just beating the play clock. Keenum. And he's got it. Got his man on the end round. Complete. And they'll be
going to lollipop it in the middle of the field. Bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to say don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Now Keenum, and he takes a shot on the release. The field goal team now for the second time here today. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. And he missed it. He missed it. We talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game.
Just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs.
And down he goes on the pressure.
Running back not pick him up. What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
And pressure coming, and they got him.
Hey, Mike 52.
Off the play fake. Here's Palmer. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And he couldn't hang on to it through the count. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Returnable for Thomas. A very good return that time. They had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team. Go over again and grind it out.
Here's Keenum now on second down. And a hit jarred it loose. It's in.
Trying to get those rack yards before he secures it.
Throwing is Keenum on third down. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. A solid stiff arm. And he's taken down, but not before he gets
it. Does he have open space in front of him? He's got an escort as well, and they pick up big yardage.
A hit as he throws there in. Gurley. And he's got room. Trucks through him.
Oh, man. Right through him.
And he's.
Illegal block in the back. Offense.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And the big boys up front. They're going to stop him. Time running out here on the play clock. Throwing on third down. Keenum. And it's a short one here. Complete to the tight end.
Positioning. And tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance. That one to go, but tie game, so those two misses could still loom large.
They'll probably hang over him the rest of the way, you have to think. But now you get a fresh start. All even. Time for that defense to rise up and get the ball back.
And going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency.
Again, it's Johnson across the 30 to the 31-yard line.
In terms of levels, first-level defensive line, second-level linebackers, third-level defensive backs. And that run, that was what we call a first-level run, and it was stopped by a second-level player. That's why I'm sitting here next to you.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he'll push his way up to about the 40. Now a handoff, Johnson, and he'll be brought down at about the 40. Defensively expecting pass. They've got six DBs out there. Throwing is Palmer. It's brought in by Floyd, and he'll get this one. Confident, supreme confident.
Big time confidence that he would make the play for him, and he did.
Completes it over the middle to Floyd. And he's brought down. Really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what's a receiver quicker?
Right now, blue 58.
And we've got
false start offense.
Let's go, let's go. 1-18.
Again, it's Palmer. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And they'll be
with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
He saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
Jaron Brown.
Half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football.
Ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to
come. Last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And great.
Oh, my man, I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team. Stop him here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, really emerge in the NFL.
Yeah, as a defensive back, 16 tackles for a loss. But now, how about where he's at now?
Yeah, truthful.
And Catanzaro's kick is right through. Big enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten six out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
Oh, he bowls over him. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up. Led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal?
And no. Check. Patriot.
On second and 10, Keenum. And incomplete there. A nice convert here on third.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's. Wow. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football,
3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased. And now, good pickup for first down yardage. And that is a tough one to cover. The angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cut, it cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
Now it's Palmer. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll go. Dawkins says, get it to him in space. Let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end, position is a major part of offenses. So they game plan for them. More double coverage. Sometimes they take a really good cover play for the second consecutive week.
Now Palmer on third and long. And probably the wise decision there. This to make it a two-score game. And Catanzaro's kick is right through.
The fact that they were able to bleed some time off the clock and put points on the board, even if it's only three, that could turn out to be the drive that ultimately wins them the game.
Now the return man. This is Benny Cunningham. And he's able to get it across.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency.
Build off of, that's what they're looking for here. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Keenum going to throw, and he fires.
Let's go!
From the gun on third down, Keenum. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. He's moving quickly to the line. Keenum on first down. And he finds a man with a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. Zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper area. See what they try and do on this play. Do they try and take a shot, or do they just try and get to the two-minute warning?
He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Time for a break. Again, Keenum. Completes it right side to Britt. And he'll go.
Be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And incomplete, he dropped it.
On any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes.
Up and backing up and backing up, eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Surveying the field, looking left side, and it's complete. And on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. Just to get it back to a one-score game. And Zerline's
bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. And I said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover.
On the ground, this is Johnson. And he'll be stopped up. And the Rams on third down, Johnson fighting his way down to about the 35. And Catanzaro's kick is right through. A very common theme. He's now hit 5 of them in this game.
Yeah, Brandon, as an offense, you hate that you've had to call on your kicker so often, but you have to love the fact that time and time again, he's come through.
And a nice
down the clock. As you said, keep him in front. Walk away a victor. That's a pretty good feeling at the end of the game.
Heads held high.
His versatility, being able to rush the quarterback from any angle on the defensive front, and usually...
And this is intercepted, and that should do... They go down to a knee and a sigh of relief as they are into the win column for the first time this year. So a two-game lose... So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This is...